Hey friends, Andrew here, hope you're well. So my MacBook M2 Air here, this has 8 gigabytes of RAM and I love this laptop. In fact, I still use it every day, but I just wish I had paid a little more for the 16 gigabyte RAM upgrade. But I get it, Mac upgrades can be confusing and even intimidating. So here is a video to help you weigh up the best Mac configurations for your needs and why you should honestly probably just pay for the RAM upgrade. So let's talk about what RAM actually is for a quick second. RAM stands for Random Access Memory, and it acts as the short-term memory of your MacBook. Not like amnesia though, but think of it as the Mac's way to quickly store and retrieve information. Your SSD or hard drive, on the other hand, that's where the Mac stores long-term stuff, things like your documents and apps. RAM stores data that's used and processed in real time. An easy way to think about it is seeing RAM like your office space. It's a place where, you know, you can work on tasks. The larger the desk that you have, the more papers and tools and computers you can spread out and work simultaneously on. Now, not everyone needs that bigger office space. Some professions need that extra multitasking ability than others, like, let's say, video editors or engineers. If you're someone who just uses Apple's default apps like Safari and Notes without ever multitasking, then theoretically, you're probably fine with a base MacBook with 8 gigabytes of RAM. But you see, base MacBook Pros are still being sold with 8 gigabytes of RAM, and that has some people fired up. But okay, really, what is the real life usage and advantages of more RAM before you upgrade? Take my M2 MacBook Air here as an example. I've been happily using it for 1.5 years now, coming to 2 years, but I really do regret not bumping the RAM up to 16 gigabytes. So I got this laptop as an everyday laptop for simple tasks, things like web browsing, emails, and simple team collaboration stuff. Tasks where an average budget laptop is more than enough. But soon enough, the more I used my MacBook Air M2, the more I found myself having to constantly exit unused apps, close tabs, and avoid multitasking altogether. Because anything more than a few apps open, and you can see in Activity Monitor that I'm often very close to using the full 8 gigabytes of RAM. So I found this to be the case ever since upgrading to the latest Mac OS Sonoma particularly. So the problem is upgrading RAM on Apple is a once-off choice. You sort of just get that choice up front when you're ordering, and it's also ridiculously expensive. $200 to be exact for the jump from 8 gigabytes to 16 gigabytes, and then 32 gigabytes is an extra $200. Unless, of course, you get the Mac Pro, which has $800 RAM upgrades, increments up to a whopping 192 gigabytes of RAM. And it's also very likely the wholesale price that Apple pays is significantly less than they charge. Consider it the Apple tax we have to pay to enter the walled garden of Apple. But to be fair though, Apple has done a great job juicing as much as they can from 8 gigabytes of RAM as physically possible. Half the reason is Apple's unified architecture. So Apple makes everything in-house, as we know, from the operating system to the hardware components, whereas let's say a Windows laptop, all its bits and pieces are sourced from different manufacturers. And what this means is Apple's end product is simply more efficient in performance, energy consumption, security, and software compatibility, because everything's just made in-house. Macs also use this thing called memory swapping and memory compression techniques, which help get the most out of the physical limitations of 8 gigabytes of RAM. So memory swapping is when your Mac manages its RAM by moving less important tasks to a storage device so we can allocate more memory to intensive apps and tasks. It's sort of like shuffling things around the desk that we talked about earlier to make room for your bigger task you want to focus on right now. And then memory compression basically condenses data to free up space for more tasks, sort of like vacuum sealing food so you can fit more into the fridge. Memory swapping and memory compression both are techniques that aren't unique to Mac, by the way, but they're great at helping us get more out of the limited 8 gigabytes of RAM. Though Apple's VP of product marketing himself, Bob Borsches, said on a podcast, 8 gigabytes on an M3 MacBook Pro is probably analogous to 16 gigabytes on other systems, which I'm not so sure about that. At the end of the day, 8GB of RAM is still physically limited to, well, 8GB of RAM. Sure, Macs might be well optimized for low RAM usage, and Apple has done a great job maximizing performance from 8GB of RAM, but the 8GB ceiling is pretty low, especially when you're still dealing with third-party software outside the Apple ecosystem. Okay, so should you flat out just avoid 8GB of RAM with your next Mac purchase? I think with the way software and Mac OS is evolving, 8GB has long been a bottleneck, and in an ideal world, Apple will begin to ship Macs with a base of at least 16GB. And let's not forget, the 8GB of RAM is actually more limited on Mac chipsets, specifically the M chipsets, than we think, because the integrated system on a chip layout, SoC, the RAM is actually shared between both the CPU and GPU, which means more load for 8GB of RAM to carry. It's already got to the point where the CPU is more than capable, but the machine is bottlenecked by that 8GB. If you plan on keeping your MacBook for more than a few years, or just have the cash to spend, you'll thank yourself later on spending that extra cash to get the RAM upgrade, where 8GB probably would have left you behind the curve sooner than you think, particularly with future macOS releases. We're already seeing it for intensive features like FaceTime effects, hand gestures, center stage, and things like that. So upgrading your RAM now could save you from having to invest in a new machine sooner than planned. So my recommendation, just upgrade to 16GB of RAM. I think it's a worthwhile investment for most people. It's an obvious choice for creatives, developers, and gamers, but it's also pretty beneficial for students who have lots of documents and PDFs open for essays, or the average person just planning their trip to Italy and has dozens of tabs open for research. The extra RAM is really going to help you avoid unnecessary bottlenecks and slowdowns, and help support future software releases. And let's remember, storage can be expanded later on, but RAM is literally soldered onto the Mac's motherboard. So most Macs today don't have the option for aftermarket RAM upgrades. Apple's RAM pricing is a hard pill to swallow for someone who wants to put every dollar to good use, but the trade-off is a more future-proofed, versatile, and robust Mac. And maybe, just maybe, if we all begin to select the 16GB option, Apple may finally ditch the 8GB option altogether and finally give us 16GB as standard. Hopefully that day will come soon. If you agree, drop a like on this video. And if you made it to the end of this video, drop the code word comment RAM and I'll give it a like. And what's your own thoughts on this topic? Do you think that 8GB should still be an option? Also drop a video right here to my review of the M3 MacBook Pro, my new daily driver laptop I've always been loving. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.